Let's talk about how you would fix a game. How would you approach this?
Firstly, we need to know if that particular football match has got bets, are the books open for these matches? That is the first thing we have to look at. And then we look at the team. If it is corruptible, are they vulnerable? In Zimbabwe was in turmoil at that time. So when I approached the captain, I brought him out. We had a meal before we bid farewell to one another. I asked him if it's possible. Like, it's like a bait. If he bites the bait, then it's okay.
So once you've had this initial conversation and you've gauged interest from the first player you've approached, what is the next step?
I would use that person to bring in players whom he is very close to, whom the players he can trust.
Does it matter which players? Are there some players on the team you would prefer to have involved in the fix?
Not exactly. I fix matches with just one single player. It is the commitment of the player. But of course, we would like to have the goalkeeper, we would like to have the defenders, then the strikers. If you have the strikers, you don't have the goalkeeper and all, then you draw out a strategy whereby we are able to achieve the result.
What was your most satisfying fix and why?
Satisfying fix. When I was able to fix the football warm-up friendly matches, it was the summit of my business. So it was very satisfying that I was able to, because I'm a match fixer, and I'm able to fix a match of this caliber.
It strikes me that you took a lot of pride in your work. Would I be accurate by saying that?
Yes, I'll say I was like a businessman. It was like I had to sit down, I had to do a lot of work on my own, write emails to these associations, and it was more like an office job. You know, at the end of the day, it was a clandestine business.
Some would say that beautiful sport is now a much uglier sport because of the behavior of people like yourself. How do you respond to that?
It is no longer a sport. It is more like a business now. So I think we're just trying to make money out of this business at every level. It has become business.
Do you feel any remorse or any regret for any of the things you've done fixing games?
I'm sitting on the side where I want to make money, right? And I do feel sorry for certain matches that I have fixed, but there are matches that I have fixed and I have no regret fixing it.
Do you miss it? Do you miss match fixing?
Not exactly. I miss gambling more than I miss match fixing.
And for all that Perumal claims to have profited from his illicit activities, what does he have to show for it?
How much money do you think you made for yourself through your career?
I've probably made about $5 to $6 million.
US dollars?
I would say around the region.
And what happened to it?
I lost it in gambling. I enjoyed it, lost it in gambling. Had a good time. I didn't really spend on anything worthwhile. I had a good time. That's about